How can you do troubleshooting on your GEN24 Plus device when you have a full face backup system? This is what we are going to show you today in our short video, in our short how-to video about how to do the troubleshooting when you're installing a full backup power system and you have problems by the commissioning or for the installation. So today we are going to show you some hints and tricks on how to solve that. And of course, very important, whenever you install a full backup power system, you have to check, first of all, the web interface of the GEN24 Plus. So therefore, first thing that we are going to do today is to show you something about the web interfaces and the changes that you can do directly in the web interface. So therefore, first of all, let's have a look directly in the GEN24 Plus web interface here. Therefore, as you can see here in the web interface, on the left-hand side, you can go to the settings page and therefore enter the device configuration. After typing in your technician password, you can instantly enter the settings here. Under device configurations, you find the point function and IOs. And here you can find the backup power as well as the load management. Under backup power, you can now do the drop-down menu and check here if the full backup power mode is being selected as well as the nominal voltage of the system. Yeah, furthermore, on the right-hand side, you can see the pin activation of the full backup power system. First of all, we have the activation of the backup power interlock. So this is default pin 0. Then we have the backup interlock feedback, pin 7. And then we have the open grid relay feedback. This is default pin 6. If you are now changing the pin, for example, to pin 1, then we get an error code. It says that pin 1 has multiple assignments already. So this can be one failure when you assign the pins incorrect to the backup power solution. Then you will get the failure code. After that, for example, like in our case, the reason is that we use the pin 1 already for the load management. With the load management, you can control different loads within the system. And since we have pin 1 already used here in the load management, we need to switch the pin to a different pin that is not set yet. After that, you can check if the backup power is being activated with this little switch here. And when you have done all the configurations correct, you can hit the save button and therefore make sure that the backup power configuration is being set correct on your inverter. Yeah, furthermore, of course, you can check if the emergency power cabling is being implemented correctly, and therefore we are showing you the pin configuration here in the screen. And therefore you can make sure that whenever you're doing the configuration between GEN24 Plus and your backup power box, that you make sure that the pin connections are being correctly set and that you have good connection quality. Furthermore, when you're making sure that you're setting the pins correct, you can also do a voltage measurement of the pins and make sure that they are connected to each other. This is also the possibility whenever you have problems with the connection between the GEN24 Plus, the smart meter, and the backup power switch. Yeah, furthermore, another big problem is what happens when your GEN24 Plus enters the backup power mode, but switches off again after several seconds or minutes. This is often the case when the system is being overloaded. And this is due to the fact that too many loads are being within a system and the combination of the PV battery system and the inverter can't handle the high power of the household load. So therefore, please always make sure within the backup power system that you are achieving the highest power possible by choosing the right inverter and battery ratio to make sure that the system fits to each other. Second up, you can just put off the loads that are being into the household. So whenever you have, for example, a heat pump or electric vehicle charging station, or even, for example, a heat water production site, then you can make sure that to power off these big loads and switch them on after each other. And then when the backup power system turns off again, then you know there is a limit and you can't exceed this limit. And therefore, for example, when you know there is a heat generation unit in the household and this has too high power, then you can switch it to the so-called X2 contact of the Envitec box and therefore make sure that these loads are only being operated during grid parallel times. But in full backup times, when the public grid is gone, then only the backup power loads are being operated, like the lightning of the house or the internet or the most valuable electric loads that are being into the household. Yeah, same thing goes of course for our hot water solution with the Fronius Ohm Pilot. If the Ohm Pilot is being installed within the backup power solution, then you can make sure to do the cabling, to renew the cabling and set it to the X2 contacts to make sure that there is no connection of the Ohm Pilot to the backup power mode to make sure that there is no overload within the system. Another failure can be that the circuit interrupter is triggered on always during the backup power modes. So this can have several errors, like for example the wrong NVTEC box. Whenever you are building a wrong NVTEC box in a system, this can trigger the RCD. And on the other hand side, this can also be due to an older household installation with a TNC, that it is possible that then the RCD is triggered. Yeah, I hope this gives you a little overview about the possible failures within backup power systems, and I hope you can now install the next backup power system correct. Thank you for your attention and see you the next time here at Fronius. Bye bye.